Back here at home, Starpay continues to strive to become a leading financial tech company, functioning as an e-money issuer and an operator of payment system. In 2021, it was recognized by the Philippine Central Bank as an outstanding stakeholder in encouraging digitalization amid the pandemic. Its head of product and marketing, Ryan Uy, and head of strategy and corporate development, Jan Chan, are here with us today to tell us more about Starpay. Ryan, Jan, thank you so much for joining me today.
Yes, thank
you. Really glad to be on the show.
And I'm so excited to talk about this. I mean, congrats on this award. I know this was 2021, but to be called, as an outstanding stakeholder for, of course, pushing for the digitalization of the e-finance. Let's talk more, I guess, on how do you find the current landscape of e-finance first in the country?
I think e-finance is at a very exciting point. Compared to 5 years ago, we're seeing more players in the space, more adapters in the space, and more regulations in the space. It is not yet mature, but it's developing very fast.
And we love those progress, we love those developments, but specifically, how about for e-cash wallets, for e-payments?
Yeah, so as you mentioned earlier, right, we're seeing a lot of these e-wallets starting to really thrive over these last 2 or 3 years. The pandemic really provided, I guess, an opportunity for a lot of people to explore and adapt to these digital technologies. But I think we're also realizing today that despite these headwinds that have been made in the space, there's really a lot of room there for more people to be brought in to this digital financial space. And that's where we as Starpay is trying to come in.
Now, tell us more about this room that you're encouraging people to come in. Who are these people involved? Are we talking about consumers? Are we talking about people who also still aren't aware or very much hesitant to get into the space?
Yeah, so like what we're seeing today, doing a lot of on-ground activities, we're seeing a lot of people who have yet to adapt to any form of digital wallet today. Most recently, we've seen about 80 million people reportedly now have e-wallets today, but there's still the question of that 20 million people of the population. Where are they and why haven't they adapted to these financial technologies? Something that we want to focus on in Starpay are these three A's: affordability, accessibility, and appropriateness of the wallet. So affordability meaning to make sure that the transaction fees for our users are low, as well as for our merchants.
How much is this transaction fee?
We're looking at no fees actually for like the most common bills that are that can be paid on the platform today. And we're also offering some of the highest discounts for electronic load on our platform today across any e-wallet or digital platform. Apart from that, we also want to make the wallet accessible. And by making it accessible, we're not just looking for people with driver's licenses, passports, and the PhilSys ID, which of course is still being rolled out today. Mm-hmm. We're also trying to bring in more people whose primary IDs are actually still the secondary IDs today. In doing this, we hope to be more inclusive and bring in these third, fourth tier municipalities and really help them to come on board into Starpay. Last but not least, it's about that appropriateness. We want to focus on the essentials in Starpay. We are bringing in a new crop, a new generation of people who have not yet been exposed to these technologies, and we need to make it inclusive for them. But making it inclusive for them also means to make sure that we share with them what are the essentials that they could be using on the platform. Bills payment, electronic load, money movement functionality. These are the things that we know, although they have not yet been exposed to, they do know that they need it. And allowing them to have this in a very simple and easy to use platform should make things a lot more inclusive for everybody.
Tell us more about that, John. I think the third one, because we say that this new generation that aren't so familiar with the space are the older generation, how you would like to call it. They're not so comfortable. They are very set on their ways. So how does Starpay play a more active role also in encouraging, aside from it being, I guess, a simpler platform? Because there are fears, so many fears of theirs, especially like what of, you know, scams. So we've been also hearing in the news lately. So how does Starpay, I guess, address some of those?
Money movement or e-wallets is a business of trust. Right, so it's very important that people trust the wallet that they serve. So in Starpay, we look at it in a multifaceted way. From the moment a consumer onboards on the platform, it has to be very easy, very simple for them to participate, very clear. Right, as Ryan mentioned, very inclusive with the IDs that we require. Second, when they start transacting, the user interface is very simple. Font is big. We don't want to confuse them with a lot of different things, mm-hmm. right? And then third, we have a very strong customer service team. So we still believe that explaining financial services has to be personal and people-driven, because it's hard when it's a system or AI that answers the concerns of very ordinary people. So we have a very strong team that's very human-centric, so that when people have concerns, helping them log in, and be surprised, 30% would forget their passwords, another 30% would forget the mobile number they used, because mm-hmm. Filipinos like switching mobile numbers. But we have to walk them through, because it's really a process of taking this slowly to help the wider population adapt.
I want to harp on to what you said, that Filipinos, they love switching. But you did say that the root cause of when it comes to e-finance is trust. So how do you, that's another huge gap that you need to address. So how do you plan on doing that?
Well, with regards to trust, right, I mean, we've been seeing a lot of events, if you will, happening in the e-wallet space, and we're seeing that it's really a matter of knowing that they have someone to talk to. Mm-hmm. That's really critical for them to know that, hey, I can actually trust this e-wallet, I can actually put my funds in there. Because the target market that we're trying to address is a lot of people who the money that they're putting into the wallet, that's really all that they have.
Yeah.
So it's very critical that you take care of that, you take care of those funds, you make sure they're able to transact properly, efficiently at any given time that they need to do that. We give constant reminders to our users, of course, never to share their passwords, mm-hmm. Never to talk to anyone on the phone who says, hey, I'm from this wallet or from that wallet, and I'm going to ask for your details, right? Never share those, and that's a public service advisory right there. And also, adding that human touch right there. Our team is very, really likes to harp on that human approach, because if you don't talk to them, people to people, right? And if they think they're talking to a robot or some self-generated answer, it's not going to give them that assurance that their money is safe with you.
And now I want to ask, because you did say, I mean, the biggest part of StarPay also is that human-centric, that human touch. AI, I mean, it's the next big thing. All the companies are adapting to it. I mean, we also released, I guess, a report that at least 80 million jobs will be lost because of AI. How does StarPay, and also, I guess, you know, it is in the technology space, play into that as well? Because you also don't want to be left behind.
Right. No, we love AI. We love automating things. Technology is supposed to improve lives, right? And AI is we believe is a very exciting development mm-hmm. to improve even the financial sector. So if you remember the time when, well, I wasn't born yet, but banks used to have tellers, right, where you would withdraw cash. Eventually, they had ATMs. Mm-hmm. And of course, if you look at it, I think banks flourished because financial institutions did not have to be so worried about counting pennies. And similarly, we think that AI is supposed to help us. We will be able to do more things because some of the manual, rudimentary things that we have to do in our internal processes could be automated using AI. Even customer service, right? Because AI is now getting even smarter, where they're starting to sound like humans. And that's very exciting. Because when you have less to worry about these rudimentary things, we can start getting even more creative. Now, how can I help more people? What products can I develop with the extra bandwidth that we have?
So Ryan Uy and Jan Chan joining us for StarPay. Thank you so much, guys, for telling us more. I wish we had more time to talk about it.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Denise.